Hi, it's Paul from Wave5trade.com, and this is my daily stock signals video for Monday the 25th of June, where I take one of our many signals that our members get in the Wave5trade scanners membership and set it up. So in the members area, very briefly, our members get potential long and short fifth wave trades on the weekly, daily and 60 minute time frame. They also get intraday stochastic long and short trade signals. So I've gone for long trades today, and as you can see here, for the 25th of June, our members simply click on the image and download the spreadsheet, and the previous days are there to help build watch lists, especially on the weekly time frame. So let's have a look at the spreadsheet for today. I've chosen the 60 minute time frame today. I usually do dailies and weeklies, but occasionally I look at the 60 minute time frame as well. I've chosen one of these particular tickers to set up today. So let's have a look at the chart. Okay, so I'm using the think or swim version of our Wave5trade Elliott Wave indicator suite here. For those members that have the Elliott Wave suite, I've gone for the lows down here on the 60 minute time frame. So this is PRTY on the 60 minute time frame. I've gone for the lows down here, bar 64. And isolated the start of this potential trend. As we can see, we've had a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 down and up, and this is a current trend we're interested in, this nice long wave 3 and a wave 4 pullback. So let's just zoom in and have a look at that there. As again, our Elliott Wave indicator suite automatically labels the Elliott Wave count. So on here we have three basic filters to begin with for our scanners membership. The first filter is the wave 4 pullback coming into one of our automated probability zones here. These are our pullback zones. It's found support in the amber zone in this case, and there's an 80% probability then if it does find support, it's going to go on and make the new wave 5 high into our automated target zones up here in blue, and that's around about 1676. The second filter is the 535 oscillator. You see down here in green, the oscillator's pulled back between 90 and 140%. It's just blipped below red there on the zero. What we're looking for is that to crown within here, and that's a really good sign that the wave fours behave very well. And then thirdly, our stochastic, our false breakout stochastic. Here the yellow line at the top denotes a very strong bullish move, and when the stochastic pulls back against that and crosses over in the oversold zone, it is highly likely it wants to return to that that strong bullish move and go on and make that new wave 5 high. So they're the initial filters on our signals membership. So let's set this up. Very simple. When we've had a pullback against the main trend, we've found support, we use our 6-4 moving average high, which is on the Elliott Wave indicator suite here, and we use that for entry. So for the first candle, for the first hour of Monday's session, 1613 comes out of there, and that is our entry long, 1613 on PRTY in the 60 minute time frame. The stop loss, 1573, just below the wave 4 low there. So that gives us a 1 to 1.6 risk reward into our target zone. Nice little target zone. We must be aware though, if the stock gaps up beyond our entry point, that we don't enter it because our risk reward will be too small, and it may in fact come down and close that gap initially anyway, and we don't want to be interested in that. What we're more interested in is the stock opening within that range between our stop and entry, and then moving through our entry price of 1613, and then that momentum continuing to go long. So that's it for today. This example again was on the think or swim version of the Wave5trade.com Elliott Wave indicator suite. Have a great trading day, and I'll speak to you all tomorrow.